Add more water.
Add more water.
You're gonna be able to tell the texture of this dough. It should feel like Play-Doh.
Looking at you. Your daddy was proud. Your papa was proud. My mom, I'm sure if she saw it, she would have been proud.
I can tell this dough needs a little bit more water.
Yeah. You're gonna start to feel warm, so you just bring your hands, go all the way in. So you're gonna. So you're moving it all the way into the middle. Try to bring it all together. You're gonna feel the texture changing. So as you feel the texture changing, you're gonna see it come together.
Once I just let myself go on the camera,
and you just tap it with water.
It's good. Like I was being nervous.
The best part about all this is there's really
no. You want to put your love into it.
Yeah, there's no right or wrong way with any of this. It's very instinctual. We all have this instinct to cook and make stuff from scratch.
A lot of people don't have all this stuff in their house. Like, you know, people don't have basil all the time. People don't have stuff in the flour, you know?
Alright.
Someone needs.
And you really want to get everything that you got in the bowl.
Can you take a picture of this?
Incorporate it.
Picture. Oh my god, though, it was a pot. Yeah, I can't.
Okay, so now, a quick tip.
Is your goddaughter?
It's always better to add a little bit more water at the beginning.
Her,
so you have a wetter dough. And then you can
one
add
is better than none, right?
As you go.
I'm happy with that.
If you need to add more
one
water
person
as you go,
it's
going to get a little
great.
Bit trickier. Okay, but adding more flour as you go makes it a little bit easier. So if you're going to do anything, I would go on the wetter side for your pasta. Okay? So, I don't know if you guys can see this, but we got a pretty clean bowl here. I mean, I got no flour,
people
no water, and I have this nice
people change
dough.
They just don't.
So, let's go.
Let us see what you guys add.
Yeah, if you got anything, if you're making it along with us, please share.
She said it because my
take some videos, guys.
So see what you created.
Take some photos of everything you're doing, okay? Tag us, elevatednoms.com. Okay, at Elevated Knobs for Instagram. And then
hey, you weren't listening to what I was saying. I was literally telling you. I made sure I said it so that you could hear it, like,
classes,
on the board.
Meal prep, we can pretty much do it all. So if you need, just let us know. Put in your info. We can get it all done there. Right, so now we're going to start the kneading process on the board.
On the board. I'm pointing on the board. Yeah, I'm looking.
And you're really getting into it.
That was a perfect pasta dough, though.
You're gonna roll all the way down, and you're gonna go to the right. So as you twist, you're gonna turn. So you're gonna fold it over, and then twist. Fold, and twist. So you're just putting your love into it. This is what creates the gluten. So you wanna just continue to put it.
Alright guys, while she's doing some beautiful kneading, I must add, I'm going to start picking some basil, fresh, from this beautiful basil.
Look at you go, up. Baby!
Okay.
Shoot, you made me so proud.
Oh,
you made me so proud, look at you kneading.
Don't forget to save some pretty leaves for the end, for the garnish, because you got to make it look pretty. Right? It's
got to
be pretty.
Baby, so proud.
You'll smell the basil coming out. It's the best. We have a diffuse. We're diffusing doTERRA basil as well. So we like to always diffuse the oil that we're actually cooking with. So any spice that we have, put in here, and it just creates the aroma and the effect. It just elevates all of your senses.
It actually gets your nose and all your senses ready for what you're about to eat, so it intensifies it almost a little bit. Alright, so she's, as she's kneading, I'm going to go ahead and pick this basil, okay? Really, remember, as you're kneading, this is really a transfer of negative energy into the pasta, okay? You're transferring all your negative energy out, okay, and into good energy into the pasta, right? All the negative out.
Stress reliever.
Now, this pasta can be made with eggs if you like. Okay, not to be vegan. You can do it with water. You could try it with coconut milk. You could put saffron in it. You could do a lot of cool things. You could do.
We've made rose petal pasta where we actually put rose petals as we were rolling the pasta. And we've made red wine, pasta,
spinach infused pasta. Squid ink pasta, spinach infused pasta, you can do red pepper. Really, anything is endless. The possibilities are endless.
All possibilities. You can make meat pasta.
Let me ask, if you guys don't mind chiming in, what's your favorite pasta? That's looking good.
Oh, Jose, I was looking good over there.
Yeah, if it's too soft and sticky, it looks like it is. A little bit more flour.
Just a little bit, yeah.
A little bit as you go, not too much.
He's great.
Hey, Ash?
Yes, baby?
I just sent you a request because we can barely hear you on the device we have you guys on. Can you accept it? There you go.
There you go. Can you hear us?
I can hear us, yeah.
Great.
Better? Get in here. Gonna get my meat on. It's my favorite part.
What's your favorite pasta? Comment below. What's your favorite pasta? Mine is. It depends on the
she
day.
She thought she had a favorite pasta.
Yeah, this one has a perfect view.
That one definitely.
Yeah,
there it is. Perfect view.
She loves penne alla vodka. That's her favorite.
I know. Pasta. I try and engage with this
well,
one.
That was her favorite pasta.
And
then every pasta I make is her favorite pasta.
And now I love bucatini. Bucatini is definitely my favorite.
My favorite pasta, all time favorite, is bucatini carbonara. Bucatini carbonara.
Yes.
Alright, guys, we've been doing this for maybe 5-10
big
minutes
arms.
Or so.
Hmm?
Okay, we should have
arms,
a nice. Smooth, round,
big arms.
And
they look muscular.
Pretty good
yeah,
feeling job.
That's what I'm saying.
Be like,
hmm.
Be like,
I can't hear you.
Nice
yeah.
I don't know if you
used to back in the day.
No, it looks good.
It looks
just
good.
Just keep eating
it.
Yeah, it
looks
perfect.
Like this.
Yeah.
There you go.
Mm. It looks great.
Keep eating it so you don't want to stretch it and pull it. See,
yeah, it looks
stretch
great.
And pull.
Yeah.
Stretch and pull. Guys, it helps also if you're on the Zoom call, make go to switch to a speaker view so my screen, our screen is the biggest one so you can see exactly what we're doing. It'll take away all the other screens.
Got it.
Does my do not
yeah, make this screen
stay
bigger.
Too much.
Kind of see what we're doing.
Was
yes, there you go. Okay, so if you look, I'm kind of stretching. Okay, and then folding in, turning, stretch, turn, stretch. Really getting into it. Bless you. How you guys doing over there in Instagram land?
I'm saying
that. Alright, well, it looks like we're ready over here. I don't know about you guys, but if you're not there yet, just keep working it a little bit more.
Okay. Best friend there.
Here, I'm gonna go Instagram first. We have nice. Okay, it leaves an indent. Okay, but it springs back a little bit. All right. I don't know if you guys can see that. Okay, it leaves the indent, but it sprung back just a little bit here. Watch. All right. That's the texture we're going for. Now you can either wrap this in some plastic wrap. I like to just put it underneath the bowl. Put it underneath this bowl and we'll takes about 30 minutes. Okay. In the meantime,
we're gonna make some sauce.
We're gonna make that pesto.
It's all about the sauce.
She's learned that. It's all about the sauce. So go ahead and bust out your mortar and pestle or your food processor, whatever you got. Okay. And we're gonna do the sauce. Okay. So I have some. Make sure you guys save some. Okay, if you need to wash your basil, here's my recommended way. grab a bowl. Big bowl, and you're just gonna put a little bit of water in it. Not too much. Okay, and then take your basil and dump it in. Okay, you're gonna just smush it around in the water, okay, and then all the dirt will go to the bottom of the water. Okay, make sure you don't dump out all the water. You're gonna take the basil from the top, okay? And then there you go. You got clean basil. So, for the pesto, very, very few ingredients, okay? Now, this is also vegan, okay? So we're not gonna put any cheese in our pesto, so we have even less ingredients. It's garlic, one clove of garlic, two if you like it really spicy, okay? A nice hand, this is about two handfuls of basil, about a half a pound, some pine nuts, and some olive oil, extra virgin olive oil. That's it. That's the sauce. So,
the other garlic. Now commenting on all his stuff.
Give it a little smash.
Like, alright, you want to fuck with me?
Taste of her own medicine.
But Jeff doesn't care about
it. Stir it up. That's the biggest piece, so we need to get
just
that.
A little hustle. Like, have fun. Waste your time.
Okay, you can add a little more, a little less if you like. You don't have to add any. Okay,
she's like, I'm still winning.
You can add any type of nuts you want. You can make this with different herbs. You don't have to use basil. You can do whatever you want. Perfect. There you go. See, now what you could do, you could get some spinach and then put a little doTERRA essential oil, basil essential oil, for that basil flavor, and still get the same effect.
Like, when you're putting in the basil, you want to make sure that you're cutting it up. You don't want to use a knife. You
want
to
use why do we want to use our thing?
Him too?
Because it will all over the sit or the steel. Want to make sure it's
really
fresh, and it tastes better.
Exactly. Yes. Don't. If you can, don't cut your basil. Just use your hands, tear it up. Okay. It's the easiest way. So now we're making like a nice paste with our garlic and our pine nuts. Okay. I'm going to use a little oil, just a tiny bit, literally a drop, just to help that paste go. As she's nicely cleaning and tearing up my basil. So, how's everybody's quarantine going?
Was Lauren on the call today?
Let's talk about it. Let's see how everyone's doing.
She logged on. Logged right off. Logged right off.
No, she logged on to the Facebook one. And she said, hi, guys. But we were only on there for 3 minutes.
There's nothing like fresh basil pesto at all. If you get it before dark, you will not be losing.
But now we're going to
at least you have something.
Erica, how are you guys doing? Are you working? Erica, can you hear me?
Can I start the video later?
Alright, guys, we're just adding a little bit of basil at a time, okay? Getting it nice and broken down with our mortar and pestle here. And like I said, you can easily use a food processor if you're in a rush or you just don't want to go through the hassle. Right? It does, like I said, it does take a little bit longer. But the flavors this way, oh my gosh, they come out so much better. So much better. Like it's ridiculous. And another tip, you never want to cook your pesto really. You don't want to heat it up too much. You can't heat it up. But you don't want to cook it. You don't want it to like cook because you lose all those essential flavors that you're missing out when everything is just nice and raw.
You can also add some citrus zest or spices.
Aw, babes.
Lemon zest, lime zest.
Or some red pepper flakes.
Red pepper.
You can make a Calabrian pesto. I'm only halfway chili through pesto. Mine. It's the really hot Italian spicy chili. Yeah, we made her a nice little spicy set for her anniversary a couple weeks ago, and she loved it. A little Calabrian pesto. We had a jalapeno pineapple sauce, and we had a jade sriracha. She loved it.
I would stop it real quick. Just go, yeah, go back. Yeah.
And then it's already stopped.
Yeah. I'm just saying go back real quick.
Alright, now pesto guys, supposed to be rustic. It's supposed to be hearty.
Click on the screen. Click on the screen, baby. Click on the screen.
Okay. You get a little nuttiness. Keep going. Whatever you're putting in there.
Get ready to start it again.
Cheese, but hey, we're going vegan. We're trying to better ourselves. Why is it better to go vegan? I mean, we just got our blood types in. We're both A positive, and we're trying out this new thing called blood type diets.
Okay, so go to the very beginning.
Tell us about blood types.
Real quick. Go to the very beginning. Go to the top.
Test and figure out that we're also low in vitamin D. So we're putting together
thing I never have to worry about.
See how you feel. We've been feeling better. Our bodies are changing, so we're learning during this quarantine. We gotta eat. Like, how do we eat right now? What do we eat? And figuring out what's good for our immune system. You want to keep your immune system high. You want to keep your vibration high.
Shucks.
You didn't start over, did you?
No,
don't touch it. What are you doing?
I started over, but I pressed something.
Stop touching it.
Okay.
Yeah. Jess, your friend Jess? Jess Solstice of Jess? But tomorrow's her birthday? Thursday is 12 o'clock midnight. That girl Anna never came. When that friend requested you? Thank you. Save battery. Go dark mode.
Dark?
Think about it. I'm just saying, like, dark mode, though. That looks the same as mobile. Everything looks the same.
People want that like consistency of things looking the same.
What?
When you go on like a lot of the food pages, a lot of their stuff.
But everything's plated on the same type of plate? Chicken parm and the meatballs were on the same plate. Yeah, it was. Chicken parm and meatballs were on the same plate. Thank you. fat.
Why, watch your show?
Yeah.
No, I was just going to be about
No, hell no. Hell no. Why would you want to watch?
Because they fucking made this movie years ago, and that's what we're going through right now.
Okay, Google, turn off music. Okay, Google, turn on TV.
Sure, turning the TV living room on.
You guys are so cute. Do you know what you're doing next week? Olivia asked me. I told Poki to come over so he can join too.
Okay, Google, turn on TV. Okay, Google, turn on the TV.
Sure, turning on the TV living room.
Baby, I tried the oat milk today and I didn't like it.
You didn't like it? Because you drank it just by itself?
Yeah.
What did it taste like?
Not good.
Not good?
Mm-mm.
Knocked in the house feeding my kids 3 meals and 500 snacks a day. I'm never going to financially recover from this. Imagine, oh my god, I'm 3 kids right now. I'm fucking myself. Jesus Christ. What about your sister? Was, did you come up or did you tell her about it?
I could tell her about it. She can't. She doesn't have time for that. She's got 2 kids.
Yeah, she is.
By himself.
And he can't even. Babe, I officially have to not touch my phone. Because I fucked it up again.
Baby!
I know. I'm fucking shit.
You're missing out, man.
How do I stop it? I'm there and you're gonna go over there and not touch my phone.
Baby.
Hmm?
Baby.
Yeah.
You weren't supposed to touch your phone, my love.
I know, but I did, so now I'm gonna go back and then come back and do it. Oh, look, this is Erica's passport.
Yes, yeah. Can't see.
Oh.
Thank you.
Seth Rogen is on Instagram showing how he rolls a joint.
Huh?
Seth Rogen is on Instagram showing how he rolls a joint.
Who is?
Seth Rogen.
Nice.
Right?
Morning, Steve.
That was the card in my bony tray is because that's the tray I use for the tuba string so my shoes don't mix. Yours is still recording?
Last time I checked.
Yeah, it is. Oh, that's me sending it to you. Baby, how do you record with audio, or does it automatically do it with audio?
You press the little hold the record button for 3 to 5 seconds.
Which one?
The record button.